Sukra Joshi was born on 1894 AD as the son of Madhav Raj Joshi and Ratnamaya Joshi to the Newari family. Sukra Raj Shastri, whose original name was Sukra Raj Joshi's ancestor, were from Patan, whereas they were living in Vera Singh, Kathmandu. As his father, Madhav Raj Joshi was a pundit, he was active in social reform. Father Madhav Raj Joshi was the leader of an organized campaign for social transformation during the autocratic rule of Rana. Father Madhav Raj Joshi not only opposed the traditional unnatural ritual of deaths in Newari society at that time, but also boycotted them. Father Madhav Raj Joshi did not follow the custom of crying at the funeral of his close relatives, feeding the relatives repeatedly, keeping meat at the funeral, weeping from the streets when the relatives came to the family of a deceased, and repeatedly making unnecessary donations to the priest in the name of deceased. Prime Minister Chandrasamsher used to call his father Madhav Raj Joshi as Madhav Raj, the teacher of all, and could not tolerate him because he was trying to improve religious blindness. His father was a leader of Arya Samaj. Father Madhav Raj Joshi was summoned to Singhadarbar and beaten very badly. Sukra Raj Joshi and his brother Amar Raj Joshi were removed from the school and were declared as untouchables. After his release from prison, 18 months later, Madhav Raj Joshi went to India with his wife Ratnamaya and sons for proper education of his children. Sukra Raj started his primary education at Darbar School and took higher education from Gurukul College, Uttar Pradesh, India. Shastri, who received Shastri and Bachelor degree from Gurukul Vidyalaya, is said to be have named Shastri from Joshi due to this great knowledge. After that, Sukra Raj Shastri worked as a professor in different parts of India. He also wrote a book called Swarga Ko Darbar. Shastri was the headmaster of Dayananda Arya Samaj Vidyalaya in Allahabad, India. After graduating in English from Punjab University, he entered Nepal. Sukra Raj's first marriage was in 1923 AD with Parvati Devi Gorkhali, daughter of Kharka Prasad Gorkhali, but she died soon. Later on, 1937 AD, November 21st, Sukra Raj Shastri was married to Dharma Bhakta Mathema's sister Menika Devi Mathema. Sukra Raj Shastri, under the policy of Arya Samaj, became active in the campaign against superstition, illiteracy, caste, untouchability, child marriage, and social upliftment of women. He also began to oppose idol worship within Hindu society. Around 1937 AD, Sukra Raj Shastri opened the Nepal Civil Rights Committee in Bhotahiti, Kathmandu. In 1938, November 28, a public meeting was held in Indrachok to demand civil rights. In the meeting, committee chairperson Sukra Raj has raised the issue of civil rights on the basis of Vedic mantras. That was the first public meeting of the People's Revolution of Nepal and also the source of martyrdom scandal. Another speaker of the assembly was Martyr Gangalal Shrestha. After listening to the inspiring speech, flowers were laid on Sukra Raj from all sides by the people. Ranas was scared by this incident. Then a conspiracy was hatched against Sukra Raj Shastri. Sukra Raj was arrested the next day for such a small matter. At that time, Padma Samsher asked him, "Did you get up and speak openly? Dare to pronounce Vedas being a Newar?" Sukra Raj replied, "I have a habit of standing up and speaking to keep my conduct pure and to be fearless. I am thankful to Maharaja as you have made a law not to marry a 6 to 7 years old girl." Sukra Raj Shastri said, "There is no law or scripture that says one cannot preach Gita Veda and Brahman Sutra by being born in a Newari family. This is my right. The Ranas became angry after listening this. The Ranas offered him to plead for forgiveness and he would be released. On hearing that, Sukaras replied, "What crime have I committed and should I apologize? If I have committed a crime, I should be punished. But I will not apologize under any circumstances." After answering this, he was chained and sentenced to 3 years in prison. When Ranas were unable to chain him, Sukaras has said, "If there is no proper chain system in the country, what else can be expected from the country?" Sukaras Sastri was jailed. There were tears in the eyes of people when he was imprisoned. 5 days after the imprison of Sastri, Sukaras' wife Menka Devi gave birth to a daughter. But within 7 days of her birth, her daughter died. Within a month, the wife Menka Devi passed away as well. Sukaras was not even allowed to meet her for the last time. In 1940 AD, Padma Samsher and Mohan Samsher pronounced a verdict with all the details of who should be sentenced to death and life imprisonment. During the 3 months of imprisonment inside Singha Darbar, the prisoners were flogged every day. In 1941 AD, January 23rd, in the evening, Sukaras started making roti, but he was not even allowed to cook and was taken out of the jail to be hanged and kept in the jail office till 10 p.m. When asked his last wish before hanging, Sukaras wanted to take a bath and recite the Gita and express his desire to hang himself. After taking a bath and reciting the Gita, Sukaras grabbed the rope hanging from a tree branch. At the same time, all the soldiers, including Nara Samsher, Hari Samsher, and jailer Kharak Bahadur Sunwar, fled when they saw about 25 people coming from a distance by burning lantern. They considered lantern to be rebellious. But when they found out that they had returned from the feast, the fleeing Rana's official returned. When Ranas came back, Sukaras was standing there as before, fearless without escaping. Sukaras Sastri was martyred after pushing a brick with his own feet. On the chest of Sukaras' shaking body, Rana had written, "Such is the punishment for the traitor." His dead body was hanged from a tree all day on January 24th to scare the people of Kathmandu. His last words were, "O God, give wisdom to these oppressive Rana classes." Seeing his son as a corpse, Madhavraj Joshi, his father, had said, "Bless you, dear. You have enhanced the pride of not only the parents but also to the country. To be a son is to be like this." Similarly, Dharmabhakta Mathema was hanged on Sifal tree on January 24, 1941 AD. Dasrath Chand and Ganga Lal were brutally shot dead on January 28, 1941 AD at Sova Bhagwati East, Bisnumati. Demonstrations of dead bodies were also held to scare the people of Kathmandu. On the morning of 24 January 1941 AD, the Nepali people found Sastri hanging from a tree in Pachali, Teku. At that time, he was wearing Dambar Kumari's clothes, a grey voto sent by her mother from home, and a white kamsa with a blue smooth edge. He had a long beard. Throughout the day, Sastri's body was demonstrated to frighten the Nepali people. The killing of four convicts in January 1941 AD in different parts of Kathmandu caused a great stir in Nepali society. Due to the resistance of Nepali society, the Rana regime collapsed in 1951 AD and the establishment of democracy was declared in Nepal. Sastri, who wrote many books in Nepali and Sanskrit language, was a person with a good knowledge of Sanskrit, Nepali, Newari, Hindi and English. That is why Shastri is also called Sahit Siromani. Shastri's major work include Sanskriti Pradeep, Swarga Ko Darbar, Vedic Sandhya, Dharma Pradesh, Nepali Barmala, etc. It is believed that Shastri was executed more for his work and social reform and efforts to develop his mother tongue Nepal Bhasha than his involvement in politics. Shastri did not belong to any political party, unlike the other three martyrs who were members of Nepal Praja Parishad. Sukrapath, a street in Kathmandu, is named after him. Shastri's statue has been erected at a number of places, and the Postal Service Department had issued postage stamps depicting his image. A monument known as Shahid Gate, containing the bust of four martyrs and King Trivan, was built in central Kathmandu in 1961 as well. Thank you.